Hi, Don and I want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. This year's been somewhat trying, but at the same time, the love and support that we felt from all the citizens of Tangipahoa has made this year phenomenal. We hope that all of you have a great year, and we look forward to 2023.
What a great day it is for Library Director Barry Bradford, the ribbon cutting for the big new Kentwood Library branch. $3.2 million, but with all of our efforts at showing it to people through video, you have to see it to believe it.
I think you do. You know, $3.2 million is a lot of money, but you know what? I think what a great bargain for $3.2 million to get a building this nice, this large. It's going to be the centerpiece of Kentwood for a while, and I am so thrilled that we have the opportunity to provide this town with something great educationally, also culturally, and hopefully economically.
Well, the obvious need here, I'm sure that was a big enticement for the state to kick in $1 million. Had it been proposed for Ponchatoula or somewhere else, that may not have been the case.
That's true. Maybe not. You know, one of the people who championed this was Beth Mizell, Senator Beth Mizell. She, of course, is very interested in getting Wi-Fi to all of the rural areas in the state. And, of course, this area needs Wi-Fi badly. So one of the reasons that we put this branch here was to provide better Wi-Fi. It goes out about 100 yards from our building. We have spaces for people to use it 24/7, and it's high speed. So that's one of the reasons we decided we wanted to build here after a meet.
Kentwood is rare in terms of the fact that you can't buy high-speed internet here for love or money right now.
That's correct. I think satellite, you can get satellite, but that can be problematic at times. And I guess dial-up, I don't know, dial-up, I don't even know if they still have dial-up, but you're right. You can, companies just don't find it cost-effective to run fiber up here. So, but we do have it. So.
Well, the parish is changing that, but even after that happens, which will still be a year or more in the future, not everybody will be able to afford it, and it won't roll out in all areas at the same time. So for quite a while, this library is going to be a real hub for internet usage.
I believe it will. It already has been, the old library, and now this new one will be. It's just going to take a while for the first leg of the internet circle that's going to go around our parish. We're working with the parish in any way we can to help make that happen too. But yeah, we're here now, so if people need internet, high-speed internet, we got it.
So all day you've been buttonholed by people coming up here, maybe in a lot of cases seeing this library for the first time. What are some of the reactions you've heard?
Well, a lot of people have been just overawed by the library because they know the old library. The old library was in a bank, an old bank, and it just was too cramped. And we made good use of it while we were there, but it just didn't have enough space. The people in this area use this library. They use the old one, and they're going to use this new one. They're very supportive. So I think they're very happy. I have not had anybody say anything that wasn't just very, very happy to see this building built.
One thing I've noticed, even during this filming, during this event, that there have been a lot of families here, a lot of mamas with kids, a lot of children running around that couldn't have cared less about the ribbon cutting or the television camera, but they're here just using the library.
Yes, and kids, I love seeing kids come in and families come in. We have lots of stuff for everybody in this library. We have this Omniglobe, which is really fascinating. It shows you moons and planets and the sun. We also have a great children's area over here. We have study rooms. We have a technology commons. We have a lot of stuff available for all ages, and we want to show movies here. We want to be kind of a movie theater for this area, a free movie theater. So, you know, we have a lot of plans, and we want the public's input and we want their attendance.
Well, next will come Loranger.
Yes, Loranger is next. We're already working on a building program for Loranger. We have land picked out. We'll be buying 2 acres from the school system. They have 40 acres that they purchased to build a new high school in Loranger, and we'll get 2 acres of that. And we already have worked with Representative Muscarella to get money from the state. We put in a state capital outlay request, and he's going to help us, I believe, get the money to help build a new Loranger library. Loranger is very small. It's smaller even than our old Kentwood branch. It's only 1,700 square feet, so it's very tiny. And we want to see that community, which is growing, get a much better library.
Okay, travel back. back in time to experience the Middle Ages at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. Explore the English village of Albright at the height of the 16th century and enjoy jousting tournaments, dueling, juggling, magic, and falconry. Meet the Queen. Experience the charms of musical minstrels. See real blacksmiths, glass blowers, candle makers, and so much more. And shop for fantastic and unique items you can't find anywhere else. The Louisiana Renaissance Festival.